Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Wednesday of the 33rd week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The Lord said, I think thoughts of peace and not of affliction. You will call upon me, and I will answer you, and I will lead back your captives from every place.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you. For it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, had a vision of an open door to heaven, and I heard the trumpet-like voice that had spoken to me before, saying, Come up here, and I will show you what must happen afterwards. At once I was caught up in spirit. A throne was there in heaven, and on the throne sat one whose appearance sparkled like jasper and carnelian. Around the throne was a halo as brilliant as an emerald. Surrounding the throne, I saw 24 other thrones, on which 24 elders sat, dressed in white garments and with gold crowns on their heads. From the throne came flashes of lightning, rumblings, and peals of thunder. Seven flaming torches burned in front of the throne, which are the seven spirits of God. In front of the throne was something that resembled a sea of glass like crystal. In the center and around the throne, there were four living creatures covered with eyes in front and in back. The first creature resembled a lion. The second was like a calf. The third had a face like that of a man, and the fourth looked like an eagle in flight. The four living creatures, each of them with six wings, were covered with eyes inside and out. Day and night, they do not stop exclaiming, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and who is to come. Whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to the one who sits on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before the one who sits on the throne and worship him, who lives forever and ever. They throw down their crowns before the throne, exclaiming, Worthy are you, Lord our God, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, because of your will they came to be and were created. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Holy, holy, holy Lord, mighty God.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, mighty God.
Praise the Lord in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his strength. Praise him for his mighty deeds. Praise him for his sovereign majesty.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, mighty God.
Praise him with the blast of the trumpet. Praise him with lyre and harp. Praise him with timbrel and dance. Praise him with strings and pipe.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, mighty God.
Praise him with sounding cymbals. Praise him with clanging cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, mighty God. Alleluia, alleluia. I chose you from the world to go and bear fruit that will last, says the Lord. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
While people were listening to Jesus speak, he proceeded to tell a parable because he was near Jerusalem and they thought the kingdom of God would appear there immediately. So he said, a nobleman went off to a distant country to obtain the kingship for himself and then to return. He called 10 of his servants and gave them 10 gold coins and told them, engage in trade with these until I return. His fellow citizens, however, despised him and sent a delegation after him to announce, we do not want this man to be our king. But when he returned after obtaining the kingship, he had the servants called to whom he had given the money to learn what they had gained by trading. The first came forward and said, sir, your gold coin has earned 10 additional ones. He replied, well done, good servant. You have been faithful in this very small matter. Take charge of 10 cities. Then the second came and reported, your gold coin, sir, has earned 5 more. And to this servant too, he said, you take charge of 5 cities. Then the other servant came and said, sir, here's your gold coin. I kept it stored away in a handkerchief, for I was afraid of you. Because you're a demanding man, you take up what you do not lay down, and you harvest what you do not plant. He said to him, with your own words I shall condemn you, you wicked servant. You knew I was a demanding man, taking up what I did not lay down, and harvesting what I did not plant. Why did you not put my money in a bank? Then on my return I would have collected it with interest. And to those standing by, he said, take the gold coin from him and give it to the servant who has 10. But they said to him, sir, he has 10 gold coins. He replied, I tell you, to everyone who has, more will be given. But from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. Now as for those enemies of mine who did not want me to be their king, bring them here and slay them before me. After he had said this, he proceeded on his journey up to Jerusalem. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If you notice, today's Gospel is very similar to our Gospel last Sunday, although that one came from the Gospel of Matthew about the talents. But if you see, very similar lesson, very similar general narrative of the parable, so to speak. Again, the first point that I invite you to reflect on is the whole point of stewardship. No? Again, this is another stewardship parable. And of course, we must take it within the context of our now preparing for the end also of the liturgical year. So that stewardship. And then the second is, I will invite you to reflect very briefly on the need to take risks with our faith and also in living out the mission of Christ. And then finally, that last point wherein the Lord says, to those who have more will be given to them. So just to reflect on these three points. No? First of all, about stewardship. No? The interesting thing in this version of Luke is that if you notice at the beginning, Luke introduces the gospel. No? He says, he proceeded to tell a parable because he was near Jerusalem and they thought that the kingdom of God would appear there immediately. So remember, the Lord was conscious now that he was moving towards the city of destiny, Jerusalem, where he will fulfill his mission to die on the cross and to be raised up. And of course, he wanted to explain to them that he is not coming right away, no? That the kingdom will not come right away, but there will be a time wherein he will entrust his mission to the church. So in a sense, this parable is really addressed very much to us also, no? Because it is the time of Christ entrusting his mission to the church. So here you have again the whole concept of stewardship, no? Wherein the Lord leaves behind gifts, in this sense, gold. And I think what the first important point to to reflect on in stewardship, at least using this parable, is that number one, the Lord gives us something to bear fruit. No? That we are, in a sense, expected to bear fruit, to work for the kingdom of God, to work for the establishment of God's kingdom with the blessings that we are given. And that is the whole point of stewardship. Na, sinabi nga natin sa Tagalog, di ba, ang stewardship, pinagkatiwala. Kaya dito, pinagkatiwalaan ng Panginoon ng biyaya ng ginto dito sa parable, at pinagkakatiwalaan tayo ng Panginoon. At yung pagkakatiwala sa atin ay inaasahan niyang tayo ay mamumunga. Ang ating buhay ay itatalaga natin sa paggawa ng mabuti at sa paggawa ng pagtatatag ng kaharian ng Diyos. I think that first point, to always bear in mind that stewardship also means to bear fruit, especially in establishing the kingdom of God in our world. It is not simply passive stewardship. Ano? Hindi lang yung mag-aabang tayo, alagaan lang natin na walang hindi mananakaw yung gold coin. Ano? Kung hindi, kailangan magbunga. May bunga yung pagtitiwala sa atin. That first point to reflect on. And then the second point is that for us to bear fruit, we need to take risks. Kailangan natin magtaya, di ba? Kung tayo pinagkatiwalaan ng Diyos, kailangan din natin magtaya. Kung ang Diyos ay may tiwala sa atin, if God put His faith in us by entrusting to us, then we must also take the risk upang magtaya. Remember, pananampalataya, that our faith also in God calling us to mission, in God entrusting to us the graces to build the kingdom, then we must take risk. Hindi tayo pwedeng sigurista, as we saw in the parable, no? And here again, it is more than risk, maybe just to give you a more neutral term. Our faith invites us to go out of our comfort zone. Hindi tayo pwedeng laging naninigurado. Na kailangan ang pananampalataya natin at pagsunod natin sa Panginoon sa misyon ay hinihingi na kung minsan ay lumabas tayo dun sa mga bagay na hindi tayo sanay. Kailangan natin magtalaga ng sarili, and part of dedicating ourselves is to take risks, to get out of our comfort zone. That second point to reflect on, that to become a disciple of Christ requires us to get out of our comfort zone, to stretch ourselves, no, beyond what we are comfortable, beyond what we are used to. But of course, all for the sake of the mission, not for the sake of stretching or simply taking risks. Then the third and last point is that, you know, the Lord says, to those who have more will be given. And to those who have less, the little that you have will be taken away. I think for me, this is more of when we become channels of grace. More than anything, more than accumulation, is that when we become a very, very, you might say, suke. Siguro magandang word, hinahanap ko yung word, suki tayo na maging daan ng biyaya. Kasi kung suki tayo sa pagdaan ng biyaya, then grace will flow through us to love and to serve other people. I think that, for me, that is how I would reflect on that last point of the gospel. That if we are used to serving God and serving others, then the flow of grace even becomes abundant. No? So today, let us pray for this, especially at a time when there is so much suffering going on because of now the pandemic and now the recent calamities. Let us pray that we may become, you know, very, very fruitful workers in the vineyard of the Lord, stewards of His blessings, to do a lot of good and a lot of kindness, to spread kindness during these very difficult times. In the name of the Father and of the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Gathered together as sons and daughters of God the Father, who is the giver of all good things, we reverently make our prayer. To each prayer, a response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may not be afraid of the challenge of renewal, and may the many different gifts entrusted to her be put to fruitful use. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all people may share in the earth's resources in justice, unity, and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that we may have a deeper appreciation of the importance of our ordinary lives, and that we may realize how the love of God can flow from our little acts of kindness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That doctors, nurses, and those in the caring profession may use their gifts to bring Christ's love and compassion to the poor, the lonely, the sick, the imprisoned, and especially those who are affected by the virus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the blessed dead, especially those who have died due to the pandemic, may join the Master's eternal happiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And during this month of November, the month that we pray for all souls, let us remember especially the names, the souls of the faithful departed commended to our prayers in all ABS-CBN Masses. And let us pray for all the souls in purgatory and for our own relatives and friends. So together we offer this prayer for the faithful departed.
Prayer for the faithful departed. This month of all souls, we remember all our families and family and friends who have gone ahead of us. We pray for all the souls in purgatory. Grant them, Father, eternal rest together with you, with our risen Lord, with the Spirit of life, with our Blessed Mother, and with all the saints. May we always remember them in our prayers. We ask that they too pray for us, all our family and friends who continue our journey here on earth. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, your goodness. We have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially now our brothers and sisters, those commended to our prayers. We pray also for all the souls in purgatory and all our relatives and friends have gone ahead of us. So let us pause for a moment and remember all the departed souls, most especially our relatives and friends. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem the tide of its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of the sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Again, we'd like to invite you to pray as a family, offer a rosary, especially for the victims of the recent calamities. Thank you.